So, good day, Sir Marvin Garcia. So, I am Evelyn Baybayon from POV Corpus, Masbate. My topic is related to K-12, and that is the five major teaching approaches in K-12 curriculum. First is the constructivist approach. When we say constructivist approach, it's based on the concept of constructivism. This is the belief that learners create their own understanding of the world around them, and this understanding is based on experience. People transform the information they've accumulated into knowledge and understanding. So from the word constructivist, from the word construct, which means to build, so this teaching approach is student-centered, kumbaga students' voice and choice. Kumbaga, as a teacher, you are there to guide them, but not you are there to guide them, and this approach focuses on the idea that the learners build new knowledge and experiences rather than possibly being a learning information from teachers or from the textbook. So kumbaga, you allow your students to explore their own experience, share their ideas, and build more experiences while learning. So, kumbaga, hindi na siya ito yung tinatawag natin na spoon feeding. Kumbaga, sa'yo nang galing lahat ng information. So, let your student choose what they want to do, what they want to explore, but with your guidance. So that is a constructivist approach. From the word construct means to build new ideas, new knowledge, new learning from the learners, not from the teachers or the textbook. So next is a collaborative approach. From the word collab, which means from teamwork, alliance, partnership. So in collaborative teaching approach, in order for you to gather more information, so you need to, as a teacher, there is a collaboration. So there is a try to get information from your colleague or kapwa teachers, because they have their own experiences na meron sila na wala ka, at meron ka din na wala sila. So there should be a partnership for you to mas maganda yung maibibigay mo, mag-build na partnership, not only for learning but also yung tinatawag na pakikisama at pakikisalamuha. So another example for that is project-based learning. So as a teacher, mas maganda na magbibigay ka ng activities sa mga estudyante mo na in a group. Kasi dito masusukat yung yung communication skills, yung pakikisalamuha sa kaklase or sa kagrupo nila. And not only for communication skills, but also sharing their ideas, knowledge, experiences also. So, mas maganda na meron tayong tinatawag na collaborative approach sa ating pagtuturo. Kasi But there are maraming mga estudyante na iba-ibang idea, so much better na pag nasa group sila, maririnig kung ano yung ideas ng isa, sharing, kasi teamwork siya. Mas maganda yon. Mas malawak ang matutunan ng mga learners pagdating sa kaalaman. Critical thinking, communication skills, and teamwork, doon napapasok sa tinatawag natin na collaborative approach. Next is a reflective approach. When we say reflective approach, focuses primarily on analyzing what the teacher and the learners are doing in the classroom. It encourages thinking about teaching practices and figuring out ways to improve them in an attempt to make learning process more effective or for a class of learners. So, from the word reflect, which means to think about. So, as a teacher, you must know what is your weaknesses and strength for you to help your learners be able to of course to learn. So as a teacher, kumbaga, for example, as a teacher, kung sa pila pa dapat nasa pinaka number one ka, tapos to be followed na yung mga students mo. You are there to guide, to facilitate. Kumbaga, mas malawak ang understanding, mas malawak ang pag-unawa mo, mas malawak ang experience mo. Kasi, you are there to guide. Kumbaga, alam mo kung ano ang magiging kahihinatnan ng mga estudyante mo para sa kanilang future. So, as a teacher, hindi pwedeng hanggang doon ka na lang, but in teaching, dapat there is a continuous learning. So, palawakin mo pang iyong kaalaman. Mas maraming alam, mas maganda. So, anong yung goal mo sa sarili mo para sa mga students mo? Yun yung tinatawag natin na reflective approach sa teaching. So, continuous learning dapat yung mga teacher, yung mga educator para sa future ng kanilang mga learners or students. So, another example for that is, halimbawa, a teacher. So, meron tayong tinatawag na peer observation. So, mas maganda na may ganun na na-observe ka ng mas head sa iyo, like principal or other colleagues na mas may experience pa kaysa sa iyo. Kasi marami kang matututunan sa kanila. So, tanggapin mo kung ano yung magiging comments, magiging feedback sa iyo. Kasi mas maganda yun na marami kang alam, marami kang dapat malaman as a teacher. Yun yung tinatawag natin sa reflective teaching approach. Next is the integrative approach. When we say integrative approach, it differs from the other teaching approaches in the sense that it tries to provide learners with an environment where they can make connections between the current topic they're learning about and other topics they'll come across at different stages of the curriculum. So, from the word integrative, which means joining together, there is a connection. So, in teaching, halimbawa, for example, for that is a student could work on a project that involves searching a historical event, writing a report, creating a presentation, and analyzing data. This approach not only helps students to develop a deeper understanding of the subject matter, but also enhances their problem solving and critical thinking skills. Kumbaga, sa isang pagtuturo, may pagsama-sama, kumbaga kinonnect mo halimbawa sa math, So, merong problem solving doon. So, para makonnect mo yung topic like sa art, para makonnect mo yung instead na number ang gagamitin, so, pwede ka magamit ng shapes para mas attractive. So, there is a, hindi lang math ang natutunan nila, kundi meron din art, mga shapes na dapat malaman ng mga bata, like sa elementary teachers. So, mas maganda, mas creative. Kumbaga, there is a connection, hindi lang math, hindi lang pagsosolve ang nalaman nila that particular subject, but also na-connect mo din yun sa arts. Yun yung tinatawag natin na integrative approach. Kumbaga, marader is a connection na pag-isa mo, na pag-connect mo. Mas maganda yun. So next is the last one is the inquiry-based approach. Inquiry-based approach is unique in the sense that it encourages learners to engage in exploration, investigation, research, and study. So inquiry to, from the word inquiry, which means to discover a fact, prove to be true. For example, for that teaching approach as a teacher, you allow your students to do an scientific experiment. So instead na ikaw yung gagawa, ipapakita mo sa kanila, i-model mo sila kung paano gawin. Instead of doing that, as a teacher, you dapat magpa-facilitate ka lang, mag-guide ka lang. Hayaan mo yung students mo ang maka-experience ng that particular scientific experiment. Kasi to help para sa learners to help them discover these principles for themselves. So kumbaga this instance is not only makes learning more engaging and memorable, but also encourages a student to think critically about their scientific method. So kumbaga mas maganda, mas for me, mas maganda yung ma-experience mo talaga. Kasi maglo-long last yun. Pag hindi mo makalimutan yun na experience, daladala mo yun hanggang sa pagtanda. Don't allow your students na spoon-feeding. Hayaan mo silang matututo. Kumbaga ganun. Mas magandang ma-experience kasi mas mapapaisip sila kung ano dapat ang gawin. Kasi na-experience nila, na hands-on nila ginawa yun. Yun yung tinatawag natin inquiry-based approach. That's it for my report about the five major teaching approaches in K-12 curriculum. And thank you. Good day. Again, I am Bay Bayon Evelyn from PUB Corpus. Thank you po.